everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm very excited to show you the first video of my series in which I will interview various professionals related to the math career path. This includes actuaries, data analysts, data scientists, statisticians, software developers, and more. And if you have any suggestions or any person you want to interview, feel free to let me know in the comments or on our channel or Facebook group. My name is V. I am a qualified actuary and I'm currently working in the risk function for life insurance companies in Canada. So my mission channel is to help you study smarter, work better, and live happier. If you like this video and want to know more about careers in math, don't forget to subscribe as I will have new videos every weekend. So as an actuary myself, my first special guest is of course also a fellow actuary. So if you watch my other videos about the actual roles, you know that we can work in many different functions. So today I will have Logen, who is a product and pricing actuary, to share about his experience and his actuarial career path. Hi Logen, I'm very happy to have you here with me today and thank you so much for doing this. I know you will have many valuable insights to share. So first of all, can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
So I'm Logen again. I'm a Malaysian and a fellow of the Society of Actuaries. I went to Canada for my undergraduate studies at the University of Waterloo, studied actuarial science in the cooperative program, and came back to Malaysia after working full-time in Toronto for about a year. I'm now a product actuary with MCIS Life in Malaysia with about 8 years of experience in product development, pricing, and reinsurance in this market. I really, really enjoy my work. I really do. In product development, I think I've really found my calling. Using my actuarial knowledge to come up with product design, recommend strategies, and see the impact to the business and customers is really very satisfying. I started my journey on actuarial exams in 2006, a year after graduating from high school, because I just wanted to test whether I really liked actuarial science or not. So I started just taking the exams, even though I didn't have a background. And I received my fellowship in 2015. It was a long 9-year journey with sprints, breaks, and finally relief at the very end.
I totally understand that feeling. Why did you choose to become an actuary in the first place?
Okay, I'd like to take the liberty to split this question into two questions. Firstly, why did I choose to become an actuary? And secondly, why do I continue to choose to be an actuary? So why did I choose to become an actuary? Honestly, this was a really easy choice for me. My dad is a maths graduate who had an unfulfilled dream to be an actuary. And since I liked math, he encouraged me on that path a lot. Also, my older brother is an actuary. And being a younger brother, I felt I could do anything my brother does. So there you go. That's my reason. And the second question I'm writing for myself, why do I continue to choose to be an actuary? I love this profession for many, many reasons. I can go all day long on this if you let me to. But I'll try to pick my three favorite things about being an actuary. Firstly, the close-knit actuarial community worldwide. Just look at the both of us. You know, we are in two different parts of the world, but we connected so quickly. Actuaries really enjoy a close bond transcending any borders. And you know, we are half the world away from different communities, yet we are so connected thanks to being actuaries. This is really wonderful. The second point that I'd like to pick is the personal development and character development that we get to enjoy being actuaries. I dare say that almost without exception, actuaries are good, honest, and hardworking people. This is not by accident. I believe this is by design, and I can speak about that later as well, but I really believe in this. And the importance of integrity in our profession is so central that we ourselves develop integrity as a central feature of our personalities. This is truly rewarding in so many ways beyond the workplace. And the vast sea of actuarial knowledge also means that we are perpetual learners. We really can never stop learning, and that makes us learners. And being open to learning is by itself a very rewarding experience. And the third point is the high respect and recognition of our qualification worldwide. I don't think I need to elaborate on this point.
Yeah. So I like that you comment both the reason you decided to pursue an actuarial career path and what made you continue with it. So how did you decide between the Society of Actuaries and the Casualty Actuarial Society at the beginning?
So I'll give a bit of background to explain to the viewers in Asia what is property and casualty. So life insurance in North America usually leads to the Society of Actuaries part. And general insurance, in Asia, we call it general insurance. In North America, it's called property and casualty. And in North America, that leads to the casualty and actuarial societies part. So my choice between SOA and CAS is tied to my decision between life and general. It really happened back in 2007, when I had my first choice between two offers for my very first internship. I had two really good offers from Manulife, a life insurance role, and Economical Insurance, a general insurance role in Waterloo. Both of them were in Waterloo. I liked both of those roles and I had a really great interview experience in both places. It was very hard to decide. I took many days to think about it. And finally, I just took Manulife because I recognized Manulife from back in Malaysia as well. And it's a global MNC insurance company. And definitely I had no regrets making that choice. And in my subsequent internship placements, I got more and more senior opportunities and more interesting opportunities in life insurance and reinsurance. So naturally I would take the more interesting opportunities just because of where I was at that time. And then I just kept going on the life track and there was no turning back. You know, once you're so senior, you know, you don't want to turn back and start all over again on general insurance. So that's how it went.
So which FSA pathway did you end up taking and why did you choose it?
I took the individual life and annuities track. So this discussion was back in, 2010. So Johnny Lam was my supervisor for my internship in Canada at Munich Re at that time. So he was my supervisor and mentor. I learned many things from him and I continue to practice many things that he taught me. He advised me to take the path that would be the most easiest and natural to pass exams. So it's as simple as that for me. And I had already worked in life insurance and reinsurance for 6 terms before taking my first FSA exams. So the individual life and annuities track was my natural choice just because I've already been working in that field for 24 months, really. Yeah.
So that totally makes sense. And I think a lot of us choose the path that we find the easiest to achieve the fellowship. And thanks for sharing your path to become an actuary. So next, can you let us know what is your typical day or week as a product and pricing actuary?
In my current role, no 2 days are the same. If there's a common theme across all my working days, it is that I talk to people a lot. My team members, colleagues from other teams, senior management, reinsurers, distribution partners, sometimes regulators, sometimes agents, and now currently a lot on LinkedIn with my actuarial and non-actuarial community. This is a crucial part of my role. Nobody tells me to do this, but I have to do this. Reason being, being in product design, serendipity is very important. Ideas don't strike when you do market research on an analytical way, on a spreadsheet and compare different products, and then you come up with an idea. It doesn't come like that. Innovation and ideas occur by accident, but you need to engineer that accident. So the best way to engineer this accident is to have a lot of conversations, observe a lot what a lot of different people are saying, take it in, you know, go beyond the actuarial profession. So that's what I try to do on a daily basis. And in that process, then ideas get you know, just joined together and then you come up with something. So that's a crucial part of my role and that's where I deliver the most value right now. And in terms of work responsibility, stakeholder management, discussion of ideas and strategies, guiding and mentoring team members, these are the most crucial parts of my responsibilities right now.
So you have experience working in the US, Canada, and now Malaysia. How is it working in multiple countries? Are there any differences in the working environments?
It's a really valuable experience to work in different countries, and I encourage my peer and fellow actuaries, all of us, to try it out. And it's at least 2 countries, if you can. And even better, if one is in a developed country and another in an emerging or even an undeveloped country. The reason for saying that is only when you experience these two vastly contrasting countries, the environments, then you truly appreciate what being an actuary is all about. Let me give you an example. So in Canada and the US, the actuarial industry is very mature in terms of the actuarial profession and insurance development. You have a huge resource pool. I'm very grateful to have started my actuarial journey in these countries and to be able to observe and learn from the vast knowledge and experience pool there. Now, when I came back to Malaysia, Malaysia is a developing country, though I would like to add it's quite highly developed when compared to other countries in our region and many other countries. The awareness of the actuarial profession is also very high. And we are in an interesting period of growth, both for the actuarial profession and in the insurance industry. And it's really a good time to work over here in Southeast Asia as well. So what I'm trying to get at is, you know, when you observe a developed country, you learn certain things that you can come and apply in an emerging country. And often you are the one with a unique idea and a unique insight that other people don't have. So that is our, you know, the biggest contribution you can have. And implementing a new idea is much more difficult than just working with an existing idea in a developed country. That by itself, it, you know, develops us a lot more. As for the working environment, I highly value the importance of work-life balance practiced in North America. In Malaysia, it varies from company to company, and everyone is trying to improve, but I'm really grateful that my current company places a very high importance on work-life balance. Being in a management role now, I do my best to promote healthy working hours in my team, and will continue to do this. Asia in general needs to place a higher importance on healthy working hours and mental health. You don't get more work done by working people harder. You get more work done by getting people to work smarter, and that's what we all need to do.
Yeah. Your team is lucky to have you as their manager. We all should strive for that. So can you tell me more about the state of the actual profession in Malaysia?
Looking at Asia itself, Hong Kong and Singapore are the leaders for the actuarial profession and have a high concentration of actuaries. Japan and South Korea have high numbers of actuaries too. However, beyond these countries, there is a severe shortage of qualified actuaries in Asia. And bear in mind, when I say qualified actuaries, I don't only mean fellow actuaries. There is the fellow title, there's the associate title, and there's a new title, certified actuarial analyst. All of these are valid pathways. We need to urgently address this issue so that society can be uplifted by the growth of the actuarial profession and insurance development. In Malaysia in particular, we have a very interesting situation. There are many Malaysian actuaries who are working abroad, in Singapore, in Hong Kong, different parts of Southeast Asia, in Canada, and in US. I'm sure if you just ask around, you might find Malaysian actuaries in your community or maybe even in your company. It's very possible. Within Malaysia itself, there is a shortage of qualified actuaries. And I mean qualified actuaries, I refer to all three qualifications, fellow, associate, as well as certified actuarial analyst. It is quite common for insurers to find it difficult to fill in senior actuarial positions and opt for expatriate actuaries from other companies, from other countries, I'm sorry. On the other hand, there is a huge influx of actuarial fresh grads in recent years, and there are too few vacancies for them in traditional actuarial roles. Hence, these fresh graduates are branching out to non-actuarial roles where their analytical skills can be used. But I believe our actuarial profession needs to support this migration to non-actuarial roles and continue to allow them to be actuaries, because it is not good if they migrate to non-actuarial roles and give up the actuarial designation and profession. We don't want to do that. We want to grow together with them, right? And another observation is that progress on actuarial exams is very low, and only a very few actually qualify as a fellow as compared to Canada, the US, the UK, and Australia, and many other countries. Much more needs to be done in Malaysia and in the Southeast Asia region to motivate and enable actuarial students to progress on their exams.
For sure. As we all know, the path to become an actuary can be very challenging with the many, many, many exams and long studying. It requires a lot of self-motivation and discipline. So do you have any advice for people who would like to pursue an actuary profession? Any specific advice for those that are looking for their first job or internship?
My favorite quote borrowed from a senior actuary is, "An actuary who is only an actuary is not an actuary." Remember why we came to the actuarial professions, our love of math. Math is a lot more than actuarial science. Actuarial science is a specific applied mathematics branch. Bearing that in mind, being an actuary is not just a job, it is a calling and an opportunity to benefit society. To do this, we need to connect the dots between different domains of knowledge and be able to apply our analytical skills in various situations, not just the insurance industry, far more than just the insurance industry. Then if you specific advice to get your first job or internship, pass exams and build connections. This will help no matter which part of the world you are. I would like to add one more thing there. Try to be unique. The pioneer actuaries and the leaders of the actuarial industry are where they are because they were unique. They offered a proposition that no one else could. Now, I can't tell you how to be unique. You have to figure that out yourself. Otherwise, I would be there. So, yes, so being unique, how will you be unique? That's my challenge to young actuaries out there.
So, Logen, thank you so much again for being here today and sharing with us about your story and experience. So you can follow Logen on LinkedIn, which I will include the link in the video comment. He's doing a series of 101 applications of actuarial knowledge to everyday business problems. Very exciting. So I hope you all enjoyed today's video. And if you do, like and subscribe, as I will have many more videos about the actuarial professions, careers in math, and other tips for a more productive and happier life. So have a great week ahead, everyone.
Bye.